everybody, it's Crazy Fangirl Shabby here because we're having an amazing day. So today, we are going to be reacting to episode 7 of season 2 of The Mandalorian, the second last episode of this season. It's come so fast, guys. It's just really come rushing to the end. And next week is the final episode of the season. Cannot believe it. Oh, we were left on a massive cliffhanger and just so many emotions were rushing through all of us. Grogu and then Mando and the Razor Crest. Oh God, dude. But no. We're going to continue watching this. We literally have no idea what's going to happen. We do know that Mando Din wants to find Mayfield. He was in last season and worked apparently with the Empire. But anyway, we're gonna jump right into this and yeah, let's get into it. But before that, please remember to like, subscribe, and comment if you enjoyed this video, but also to keep up to date with all my other reactions to more TV shows, video games, and movies. So without further ado, let's jump straight into this.
I don't think that's so hard to ask, do you?
Whoa, look at Boba! There's the other guy. Dude, Boba looks sick.
But you still know your Imperial clearances and protocols, don't you?
Damn, boy. You are lucky. Well, Kara would have killed you by now.
Coming with you. But I won't be showing my face.
Is he putting Imperial armor on? Damn, I'm gonna pause it for a second. Because this is still such a touchy subject for Din. You know, like he had that little moment of kind of like what the hell is my culture and what the hell am I doing with like my identity, especially in episode 3 when we meet Bo-Katan, because you know she takes the helmet off. And we've seen ever since then, like especially when people like touch upon the subject of his armor, he kind of gets like really stiff. He gets really uncomfortable because I guess he still hasn't addressed that for himself. So I'm glad that they're doing it because I want to see more of that. And I've been wanting it for a while. So, you know, Boba brought it up and Din's just like, no, you're like disrespecting the code. But then Boba was like, no, this is my armor. This was for my family. You know, like you guys gave it. However, I want to see more with Din, like him addressing it in terms of his own morals and stuff. But already in this, you can see he's stiff as a board. Like he feels like he's doing something wrong. You can tell like he feels like he's like not respecting it. He's stiff as a board. He's not talking. He just feels so uncomfortable. I love that they're showing that through body language and not even through speaking. You can just tell. Beautifully done. Don't provoke. That's Pedro, actually. I think. It looked like the front of his face. Nice. He has been a lot in the suit this time.
Look, if you're born on Mandalore, you believe one thing. If you're born on Alderaan, you believe something else. But guess what? Neither one of them exists anymore. Hey.
That's true.
Triple one on, so what's
the news? That's true.
Is it that you can't take off your Mando helmet or you can't show your face? Because there is a difference.
That's true.
It's all the same.
He's speaking some truth, though.
Everybody's got their lines there.
Oh, God. Are those, like, pirates? Oh, thank God.
You're trying to blow the Rhydonium.
You should have left me in prison!
Oh, my God. Oh, the music. Beautiful. Oh, Din. Oh!
Valdez, I used to serve under. Will he recognize you?
I don't know.
Well, he looked at him. He didn't say anything. Is he gonna do it? Guys, wait. Oh no. Din! Oh my God. Oh no, look at Din.
small sacrifice for the great goods.
Oh no, stop. Stop, Mayfield. Oh, lovely.
Oh.
Tin looks so hot! Oh my god. No! Oh damn, look at Burba. Oh damn, he's gonna blow it up. Oh my god. Dude! What the hell, man? Oh, what's that? God, hell yes!
I will.
Just go, man! You're free! Yeah, boy.
You get the coordinates on Moff Gideon?
Oh, yeah. I was like, please don't end. Oh, no. What are they doing to the kid?
Moff Gideon, you have something I want. You may think you have some idea what you are in possession of. But you do not. He will be back with me. He means more to me than you will ever know.
Really? Okay, Rick did an episode last season too. God damn. That was so quick. Yeah, that's another short episode, so I'm hoping the next episode is longer, please. Mando. Understandable, because these, like, you know, fast-paced and all that stuff. But, yeah, you know, please give us another long episode next episode. Because, goddamn. Okay, that went... Yeah, it just... No, I did not expect that at all to happen. Because... What? Just like, you know, like even Mayfield was saying, yeah, like, you know, even like when he was saying, like, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do to like survive another day. The thing I like is that Mayfield was saying, you know, like that stuff's gone, like, you know, that creed, like, you know, like the sort of Death Watch sort of thing, because he was saying, like, that, you know, there's two different sort of things. There's the Mandalore stuff and there's the stuff that happened with the Death Watch. So, you know, and then he's saying, like, it died when the war started and when, you know, the purge happened. And he said that no longer matters. Like, you can show your face. It doesn't matter as long as you get through to live another day. But, like, I didn't expect Din to take off his helmet because, like, but that's just, like, you know, another thing is, like, he shows compassion to Mayfield because, you know, Mayfield was frightened. He was scared. He, like, I'm scared that I'll get us caught because, you know, that officer recognized him. But then, like, dude, like, the fact that he took it off, I was like, no, it's like, he's not gonna take it off. He'll, I don't know, he'll get someone and do it. And then, Pedro! I love Pedro so much. I love all his work. So, like, to see his face finally since last season is just, like, so refreshing. It's been ages. And, yeah, I did not expect that at all. Yeah, and the thing is, like, you know, me, Alex and Mitch, quick plug. Me and the Basden brothers do a podcast called The Aftermath on this channel. You can check it at the end of the video or just check it through my channel where we talk everything to do with The Mandalorian and sort of like review and break down and theorize about what's going to happen in the next episode. And yeah, in those episodes, we've been talking about the fact that, you know, there is a possibility that Din may be shamed and that Moff Gideon will be the one to take off his helmet, but it doesn't seem like that. That's a shock. Oh, I've got to say it. Pedro did a beautiful job. Like, because you could tell he was in this episode for majority of it. I love that he was, like, just presenting how uncomfortable Din was through body language. Like, he was stiff as a board. Couldn't, like, he was sitting straight. Didn't feel comfortable in fighting in that armor. You could tell. And he was, like, really on the defensive more than the offensive. Because usually when he's wearing his armor, he's using it as, like, a weapon. He's using it as defense, etc. But again, showing how uncomfortable he was, like, and even just, like, you know, when he looked at Mayfield in that moment where, like, you know, like, he killed the officers, and he just looks at him, and he has, like, tears in his eyes, and he looks like a puppy, and just, like, you know, he looks so, like, defeated, like, oh my god, like, I've taken my helmet off, people have seen, and then Mayfield's like, but no, no one's seen it. You know, you gotta do what you gotta do. And that's just, like, it's so, it's very kind of Mayfield to keep telling him that, like, even though, you know, they're not on the best of terms, you know, they had a bad patch last season, but, you know, Mayfield, you know, like, that's, like, really, like, good of him to say that and be like, you know, you don't have anything to be ashamed of if you take the helmet off, because that's no longer important. Though it may have been something that your tribe would follow, like, that's no longer there, and it's over, you know? Like, that all ended when the war happened, so I think Din's got a lot of thinking to do, even after this, like, but you could tell, like, he's not comfortable, like, he did it because he had to, so this just shows, and I think this is gonna happen, maybe next episode, he might have it ripped off, I'm not sure if he'll, maybe? Because I feel like he might, but, like, I didn't expect this episode to go the way it did. I enjoyed it, but I was just like, what? I'm hoping that the next episode is longer, because obviously it's the final episode of season 2, and yeah, I'm excited no matter what, because this season has been an absolute joy and a ride, and I cannot wait to see what they have in store for the last episode. I hope they're saving the best to last with a big battle, I'm guessing, and just, yeah, I'm excited, and I just cannot wait to see what they have in store for. So thank you guys so much for watching this reaction. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please give a like, subscribe, comment, and tell me your thoughts on the episode 7 of The Mandalorian Season 2. I will say it is not one of my favorites, but I think it is also another impactful episode, even though it was quite short. It's not as short as last episode, because last episode was only like 28 minutes. This is 33, which is okay, but at the same time, I don't know, I didn't expect it. I think I'm just a little bit in shock to seeing Pedro's face after so long, even though I've like watched all these other movies and trailers he's in. I'm just like, oh my god, he's here! Like, it's just like, it's so like foreign to see him with his face bare in this show, because Alex, Mitch, and I also have said, like, this is sort of, like, I think this is sort of set up, like, what happened with Rebels. Because with Rebels, you know, the first season, it was, like, implementing everything that had its own story, like, original story. Second season brought in Ahsoka, Darth Vader, etc. And you get to see, like, all those characters. But then they go away, and then they go back into the story. So I think this season is exactly like what happened with Rebels. So I think next season, it's just hardcore story of the Mandalorians and Din. Especially Din and Grogu. If they do get Grogu back, yeah, I'm just excited to see, like, how that works out and how that plays out for Din and Grogu if they get him back, but mostly for Din, because, again, this is his story, and we have, it's always been his story, and how, like, these other aspects have affected him, so I'm excited to see what else is in store for our dear Mandalorian, oh my god! So again, thank you so much for watching this, and I'll see you guys in the next video! Crazy Fangirl out! Woo!